they'll be able to take existing sharks, give them growth hormone, or tinker with them genetically to make them bigger, as big as Megalodon.
So your imagination, there's no end to what you can come up with.
I think that Max Outt ushers in the new age of cryptozoology. The old age is represented by Loren Coleman and other cryptozoologists, where they're looking for a finite amount of creatures.
And wait, there are other creatures that could be found. There's a possibility there's things on
life in space.
Right.
We're not at a point where we can even take that advantage of that yet, but that is true. But of animals on Earth.
So Loch Ness will become a reality now?
People could make them a reality. So there's an infinite amount of animals that can be found.
So now comes this new world order where people are now experimenting with DNA. There's going to be creatures we've never seen before.
And not only that, but once the genomes get out and computing power gets a lot stronger, you'll have anybody.
Everybody is now Frankenstein, creating their own wild and woolly creature.
You would have to have a certain amount of technical and scientific know-how, at least in the beginning, but yeah, maybe they'll have shell programs or whatever. You don't have to be even that knowledgeable in science.
Or I can hire somebody that is knowledgeable and has the
expertise
to make myself a Cherry 2000.
Which is,
a super fine babe that cooks cheeseburgers for me every night.
But wasn't that a robot?
It was a robot, but I can have a real one.
Okay, this is so cryptozoology would deal with the realm of the organic creature.
It would deal in the realm of.
But that might fuse together. They have organic computers. They have DNA computers.
I think you're 100% right. It would fuse the two together.